Tony.
Hey, Kevin. How long are you going to be here? You know?
I've still got an hour or better.
Hour or better?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to start an HF dip over here.
Okay, I'll come check on you in a couple of minutes.
All right, thanks.
It's good that he's getting help. However, he should have started rinsing immediately.
What's up?
Got HF on me.
Oh, bummer. Okay. Hang on. Where's it at?
On my arm.
Keep the bunny suit off as well. Yeah, poison control, this is the NanoFab at the University of Utah. I've got the user who just got a hydrochloric acid exposure. Yeah, University Medical Center would be the best place. We can have him up there in about 15 minutes. Okay? Okay, thank you. Okay, so they've been notified. Keep that rinsing for a couple more minutes. Contain this for a minute until... Okay. Go ahead and turn the water off. Snap this off. Now where did it get burned at?
Right up on my elbow.
And... what concentration of HF are you using?
2%.
Okay. Okay, you can see. Is that the general area?
Yeah.
Okay, let's keep this good and moist while we're on the way up there.
Okay.
You got a car?
No.
Actually, you do what?
Okay.
Let me call, let me go get 911 so we can get an ambulance right here.
Okay.
Yes, I need an ambulance at the Maryland Engineering Building at the University of Utah. I've got to get somebody up to the hospital for the hydrochloric acid exposure. Okay, we'll meet on the north side. Okay, we can walk him up there, but we need to get into the hospital. We don't have the vehicle. Okay, we'll meet you out front. And the name is Tony Olson, and we'll see you out there. Thank you. Couple of wipes. Just sit on out.
Let's review. Buffered oxide etch, or BOE, and of course, 49% HF, contain hydrofluoric acid. At low concentrations, HF will feel like water when spilled on the skin. burns and other effects will not become apparent for several hours after the exposure. At high concentrations, HF may cause immediate, painful burns. No matter the concentration, fluoride ions will begin to penetrate through the skin and begin damaging soft tissue and nerves and decalcifying the blood. If a high amount of fluoride ions get into your system, it can cause heart failure, which can result in death. Hydrofluoric acid is very dangerous. Be careful when using it. If exposed to it, follow the proper procedures and damage can be minimized. When in the lab outside of normal operating hours, check on your buddy regularly. If you are exposed to HF, your first priority is to begin rinsing the affected area. You may use the wet bench sink to rinse. However, it would be best to use the safety shower. That way, you can rinse off the affected area, remove the contaminated clothing, and call for help all at the same time. It's very important to remain calm. When assisting an HF exposure victim, your first priority is to make sure they begin rinsing off as soon as possible. Once they are rinsing, get the emergency sheet and follow the procedure. Do all you can to avoid becoming an HF victim yourself. Take the proper precautions to avoid spreading the contamination. Avoid the spill area. Put on chemical gloves if you handle anything that may have HF on it. Remove contaminated gloves before using the phone. Call poison control and inform them that there has been an HF exposure. Have them inform the university hospital that you will arrive at their emergency room as soon as you can. Once the HF exposure victim has rinsed for a few minutes, dry off the affected area and spread the calcium gluconate gel over the area. The calcium gluconate reacts with the fluoride ions, preventing them from reacting with the tissue in your body. Always put on a new pair of white chemical gloves before applying the calcium gluconate. Take the calcium gluconate, gloves, clean room wipes, and emergency sheet, which contains the MSDS, with you to the hospital. To get to the hospital, you may call an ambulance or you can take someone's car. However, the HF exposure victim cannot drive. Notify staff of the HF exposure. They will clean up the spill area. Warn anyone else in the lab about the HF spill, and if possible, leave a warning at the spill area so that no one else unwittingly becomes a victim.